Right, today we'll be going to discuss about the addressing modes, right? Addressing modes for sequential control flow instructions. And after the completion of this, we will be going to discuss about instruction set of 8086, right? Mode is nothing but the way of accessing the data, how we access the data, whether we are going to put the data directly in the instruction itself or any other mode is there, right? So such a specific information, like where we need, where we place the data, whether in the instruction itself or whether we store the data in the memory, or taking the data from I/O devices, like that, the type of accessing, right? So how we access the data from input, it is nothing but addressing mode, the way of accessing the data, right? So a way of locating data or operands. So in between, I will put the answer questions, then you people should give the answer. You please inform CR, inform everyone to join for the class.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Right, so let us see that whatever we discussed in the previous class, right? So immediate addressing mode means immediately the data is available in the instruction itself. That is why it is called as an immediate addressing mode, right? Immediately the data is available in the instruction itself. Can anyone tell where the what is the mnemonic in this instruction? MNEMONIC, mnemonic. Can anyone tell the mnemonic in this instruction? Example, move AX comma 1234. Move AX comma 1234. In this, where is the mnemonic? Whether 1234 is the mnemonic or AX is mnemonic or move, MOV move, which one?
Sir.
Can you repeat once?
Move.
Hello?
Move, sir.
Move, right. Thank you. So move is the mnemonic. Mnemonic means mnemonic always specifies the type of the operation, right? Whether it is move operation or whether it is add operation or whether it is subtraction operation, the type of the operation specifies. Mnemonic is nothing but the type of the operation that you are performing over the data. So move is nothing but here, you people are moving the data, that is 1234 into the AX. So what is the source operand in this instruction? Source operand in this instruction, move AX comma 1234. What is the source operand? What is the destination operand?
1234. 1234 is the source, sir. 1234 destination.
Yes. Can you repeat?
1234
AX is the destination. Yes, right. Thank you. 1234 is the source operand and AX is the destination operand. 1234 is the source operand and AX is the destination operand. Right. So like this, source operand here in immediate addressing mode, source operand always a number, a data, right? So this is copied into the destination register, whatever we specified here, right? So that is the immediate addressing mode example. So you already used these instructions in your lab, right? In the first experiment, addition between two 16-bit numbers, subtraction between two 16-bit numbers using various addressing modes in yesterday's lab. So direct addressing mode, when we see the direct addressing mode, directly you can specify the address, offset address of the source data. Offset address of the source data. That is why it is called as direct addressing mode. So the source data, whatever is there, right, directly we can specify the offset address of the data, whatever we are copying the data from the memory, right? So the 1234, for example, if you see here, 1234 is the number, 2500, right? So it contains the 12, right? And 25001, 25000 and 25001. So here, base address is 2000 and offset address is 5000. I was taking the example, these two. So when I calculate the 20-bit physical address, then it comes like this. The zero is called as hardwired zero, right? So we can represent the same address like this. I think yesterday you have seen this kind of representation in our lab, right? Base address colon offset address. I will show it to you in today's class also, right? This is one kind of representation, logical representation. Logical representation of your 20-bit physical address, right? Base address colon offset address, right? So one number is copied here, another number is copied here. That is 16-bit number, lower order 8-bit number is copied first, and after that higher order number, higher byte is copied, right? So this will come like 3412. When we write the same number in hexadecimal form, 3412. 12 is the lower order byte, and 34 is the higher order byte, right? That is why I wrote like this. This is here we will be representing the offset address of the data, right? So you remember, this is very important. Direct addressing mode, we are representing the offset address of the data. When it comes to the register addressing mode, if anybody is having any doubt in direct addressing mode, you please ask. Don't keep silence or don't be in the mute state. That is not at all good for you people. Sharing the knowledge is very important, right? So at least you should ask the doubt in this. You will get plenty of doubts in this direct addressing mode, right? What is mean by base address? What is mean by offset address? What is the necessity of multiplying the DS with 10H, right? So this is such a kind of doubts will be there. This logical address representation, right? Segment address colon base address. Next one, register addressing mode. So this register addressing mode, the source operand is the register. Whereas in the direct addressing mode, the source operand, we will be specifying the address of the data, right? So whereas here in register addressing mode, we are specifying the register, in which register the data is available, right? Source data, in which register the data is available. So here my data is available in BX, so in the first instruction, so whatever the data is available in the BX, that is copied into AX, so it is called as register addressing, right? So the data is available in the source register, that is why it is called as register addressing mode. The way of accessing the data is nothing but the addressing mode, right? Next one, you see, register indirect addressing mode. Here, I will store the address of the source data in the register. Offset address of the my input data in the register, right? Offset address of the data is stored in the register, square bracket of BX. So what we are doing here, one is data segment value we will be taking, another one is BX value, right? So BX address value, whatever is there, this is not data, this is a address, whatever is there in the BX, it is address. So now DS multiplied with 10H, right? We will get this. After that, offset address, whatever is there, that will be added up, and we will get the 20-bit physical address. We already discussed all these things in the previous class, right? Generating the 20-bit physical address with the help of segment base address multiplied with 10H plus offset address. So its corresponding logical address, how we represent the logical address means 1000:9000. Right. So 1900 in 1900, actual number is 3412. Right. Lower byte is 12, higher byte is 34. Lower byte is 12, higher byte is 34. So this 3412, whatever is there, this will be copied into AX register. So that is the first lower byte will be stored, and after that higher byte is stored. So when you see the data segment value by typing a command d space ds colon 0, you can able to see the data like this. Have you executed the program in yesterday's lab? Please unmute your mic. Anyone? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
Have you executed the program in the lab yesterday's lab? Then did you check the data, whatever is available in the data segment for the first experiment? Addition between two 16-bit numbers or subtraction between two 16-bit numbers. Did you check the result after executing the program?
Yes,
sir. 1 minute, dear students. I don't know what will be the reason why you are not able to give the answer for my question. You executed the program. Did you check the result in the data segment? Yes or no? At least you tell me the answer. Hello, anyone?
Yes, sir.
Did you check the result? Okay. So remaining contains the offset address of the data. Right. The BX register contains the offset address of the data. In indexed addressing mode, we always stores the data in the index registers, offset address of the data in index registers. Why we use a index registers means in the H086 programming, assembly language programming, whenever we handle the string instructions, we always need to use the index registers, source index register and destination index register. Even we have the in our lab, fourth experiment is on the strings, right? So whenever we write the program on strings, either like setting the password or a display of the name or scrolling of the name, like this, whenever we write a code for the strings at that time, we need to use the source index register and destination index register. So that is why the offset address of the data will be available in the index registers for such a kind of programs, right? So in that programs, the strings will be data, right? For example, I am giving the password. So when I give the password, whatever the ASCII characters or numerics were there, so for that, I need to store that particular password in a particular memory unit. So at that time, I need to specify the address of the password, right? So in order to store the offset address of the password, we use a string instructions, right? Sorry, string is index source index register, right? So the source index register contains the offset address of the string, right? You remember that offset address of the string, which is available in the memory. So after that, the ASCII code of that particular numeric or a particular character, right, its ASCII code will be copied into the AX, right? So initially, whenever we type a character on the keyboard, right, corresponding ASCII code will be stored inside the memory, right? For example, when I store a one character on the keyboard, some people what think is non-technical people, when I type a character, capital A means, then capital A may travel through the cable or through the board or whatever they may think like that. No, capital A, it does not travel through the cable, right? So it is, when I type a capital A, then corresponding ASCII code, right, which is in binary form, that will be traveled through the cable, which is in the form of voltage levels, and it reaches to the device, that is processor or some other, right? So ASCII code, we always need to think about the ASCII code when we press a special character, or when we press a character, or when we press a numeric number, keyboard releases the ASCII code. That corresponding ASCII code will be stored inside the memory, right? So that address of that ASCII code will be stored inside the index register, right? So this index register will give the address of the ASCII code such a way that I can get the ASCII code from the memory and I can store it in the AX, right? Or AL if it is 8-bit. Most probably ASCII code will size will be 8-bit, then it will be stored in the AL, right? So 20-bit physical address will be computed like this. The effective address in this case is computed as data segment address multiplied with 10H plus square bracket of SI. Means square bracket of SI means offset address will be available in the SI register, right? So that is why it is a square bracket of SI. Clear? Any doubt? I don't expect the doubts from you. You never ask. Once again, I was giving the.
Tile to the AX.
What, ma'am?
We copy the data into the AX.
Yes, ma'am. We start copying the data into the AX. So before copying the data.
Wanting displacement first.
What, ma'am?
Displacement.
Displacement is nothing but actually when we calculate the whenever we contain the source data address, the source data address is nothing but addition of base address and offset address generally, right? So the data will be available with a displacement of 50, means we need to add the 50 to the segment base address and offset address, right? So that is important. 1 minute, right? So these base address and offset address combined together 56000, right? 56000 is having a displacement of 50, right? 50 memory locations difference. After 50 memory locations, then our data is available. It is nothing but a displacement. Actual address is 56000, 20-bit physical address, right, of the source data. But at 56000, the source data is not there. We need to travel up to 50 memory locations. After 50 memory locations, then we will get our data. So that is why we will be adding 50. Such a way that 560 and 50 in that memory location, our data will be available. So there will be a displacement in between the actual address and the data available location, right? That is nothing but 50. So for example, if you remove the 50 means actual 20-bit physical address we may get, but in that the 20-bit physical address 56000, in that 56000 your data may not be available. So your data will be available with a displacement, with a displacement means After 50 memory locations, the data will be available. So that is why we will be adding the 50. So at that particular address, the data will be available. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Anybody? So only regular people, they are asking the doubts. Remaining people is simply logging in, and what they are doing, I don't know. Right. So based indexed addressing mode. In based indexed addressing mode, the source data offset address is splitted into two parts. So some part is available. Offset address is divided into two parts. One is some part is available in BX and some part is available in SF. So what we do here is the offset address which is available in SI and offset address which is available in BX, both will be added to the segment base address which is available in DS, right? So DS plus offset address. So offset, two parts in, of the offset address that will be added up such a way that we will get the 20 bit physical address of the source data. So in based indexed addressing mode or register relative addressing mode, whenever square bracket is there, simply we need to calculate the 20 bit physical address of data. You need to remember this. Whenever square bracket is there, immediately we should calculate the 20 bit physical address of the source data. There will be no doubt. Right side, right? For example, instruction contains the three fields: mnemonic, destination operand, comma, source operand. This is MOV. MOV is the mnemonic. 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 Space. So destination operand, comma, source operand. The source operand, whenever it has the square bracket, it indicates that the data is available in the memory. Right. So at that time, you need to calculate the 20 bit physical address blindly. This is a blind thing that you should remember. Square bracket is there, means then you should calculate the 20 bit physical address. You may give the values, DS value, BX value, SI value. Otherwise, yourself can assume so and so is the DS, so and so is the BX, so and so is the SI. So 20 bit physical address like this. In that 20 bit physical address, lower byte will be there. If it is a 8-bit number, 8-bit number will be there. For example, the data is 16-bit. First lower byte will be there, next higher byte will come. First lower byte will be stored, after that higher byte will come. Right? So this is regarding the based indexed addressing. These are all the addressing modes for the sequential control flow instructions. This is the register relative addressing mode. Based indexed register relative addressing mode, right?